Brother Lawrence, you can unmute him.
Yes, sister. Sister, I am audible?
Yes, yes.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Heavenly Father, I thank you, I praise you, I love you. Jesus, I thank you, I praise you, I love you. Holy Spirit, I love you, I thank you, I praise you. Holy Spirit, you are my teacher, my guide, my helper. Holy Spirit, I surrender my mind, my ears, my tongue, my vocal cords, take control of it. Holy Spirit, help me to speak the word of God. I am not speaking. It's you, Holy Spirit of God, speaking through me. Oh, Spirit of God, I decrease and you increase me. Holy Spirit, whatever word of God I speak, please help me. Please make it easy so that those who are listening and make them understand. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Good morning, brothers and sisters. Today, I am going to talk about God's love. Today's scripture is Gospel of John, chapter 3, verse 14 onwards. And Jesus, and just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, so whosoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order the world be saved through him. Amen. Praise the Lord. This is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. When God brought the people of Israel out of Egypt, he promised them through Moses that he would lead them to the promised land. A land filled and flowing with milk and honey. The destination was fixed, and God did it because of his love for his people. And to bring them out of Egypt, they had a mentality of slavery, because for 430 years they are slaves, and God has promised them, I will lead you to the promised land. But before they reached the promised land, there is a process you have to go in your life, in my life. We all want to reach our promised land, our destination. There is a life in abundance. But before we reach, there is a process that you will always, always have to go through. And here we read, when the Israelites were going out of Egypt, there was a land called Moab. There is a king named Moab, the cousin of Israelites. The people of Israel plans to go through this land because this is the shortest way. But this king Moab does not permit the Israelites to go through his land. The people of Israel say, we will not touch your food. We will only drink water. Just give us the permission to go through, to reach our destination. And we will pay the water we drink. But this king comes with a big army. And he says, no, I will not permit. Nothing doing. So God decides to take the people of Israel to all the way around. Now has the destination changed? This, the final destination. No, it's not. It's the same. Has the process changed? Yes, the process changed. Has it got delayed? Yes, the process is delayed. But the destination to reach out the promised land God has not changed. Now, that the time the people of Israel discouraged, their hopes are broken, and when they're going all round through the Red Sea, their hearts, their spirits are broken. And that's the time the devil begins to destroy our life. When our hopes are delayed in our life, our spirits are broken. And when our spirits are broken, according to the word of God, we cannot overcome sickness, trouble, crisis in our life. That's why our spirits can be trained every day. And here is one question. How do we train our spirit every day? We can spirit our spirit trained every day by the word of God. Every day by meditating the word of God. Speaking that word over and over again till our spirits become stronger and stronger. Now here, what happened to the people of Israel? When they saw they have to go all around, they got discouraged. When hope is this delayed, prayers are made, but delayed. Our spirit is broken. We get discouraged. We get broken. That opens the door for the enemy to attack us. When we start complaining, grumbling, murmuring against God, when the people of Israel do the same, that the word of God says, serpents came and began to bite them. And thousands of Israelites died a day, in a single day. I don't know about you, but earlier when I understand, whenever I read this passage, when the people of Israel began to complain and grumbling, murmuring, God was angry with them and God sent the snakes to bite them. But it was not like that. I was totally wrong. I was thinking that God was so cruel. God has no mercy that he sent the serpents to bite his people, these Israelites. But it was not so. The snake was already there in the deserts. But as long as the people of Israel were in obedience, instructions given by God, not one of those serpents could come and touch any of the Israelites. Because they were under God's protection. The moment we start complaining, the moment we start grumbling, we tell the Lord, I don't trust in you. I don't want to listen to you. And that's the time we come out of God's protection. And the enemy is waiting there to open, when we open our mouth, when we grumble, when we complain against God. And the enemy is ready, waiting there to destroy our life. That's the time enemy enter into our life and destroy us. When the moment we start operating in complaining, murmuring, that's how the devil use those moment and destroy Israelites, by complaining and murmuring. When we begin to complain and murmur, we say, God, I know that you don't love us. Are we been complaining? If we are complaining and murmuring in our life, we opening the door for the devil to entrance in your life, in my life. And now the poison is spreading all over, not in my life, in your life, but also close to us, close to those who are those close to us. Our household can be destroyed by that. And the same thing happens with the Israelites here. That's the time they began to cry to the Lord. And they said, please forgive us, Lord. Lord, please forgive us. They come to the Moses and said, Moses, please pray to God. We have made a terrible sin by speaking against God. They've seen the power of God before, and they've seen how much God loves them. And yet they refuse to believe that God's love them, because their hopes got delayed. And they started murmuring, grumbling, complaining against God. And here What did Moses do? He began to pray to God, and God gave Moses an instruction, a way out of this situation. God said to Moses, make a bronze serpent, and every Israelite who looks at this bronze serpent shall be saved. Why was this bronze serpent nailed on the pole? And everyone who looks at him shall be saved. The serpent was the one who bit the Israelites, and they were dying. God used the serpent to show the Israelites, the enemy who was destroying you has been captured. Now he cannot move now. And everyone who looks at the serpents with faith can see that God has captured the serpent, and the serpent has no power now over the people of the Israel. Only when they began to look at the serpent with faith, the poison from their body was gone, and they were totally, completely healed. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So also today the word of God says, just as the Moses lifted up the serpent, so also the Son of Man, Son of God, shall be lifted. Here Jesus nailed on the cross, and every sickness, disease, every sorrow, and every grief, every curse, every bondage, God is saying it has been captured and nailed on the cross once and for all. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The devil who has been set loose to destroy human race has been captured by Jesus and nailed on the cross once and for all. Sin has been captured. Death has been captured and defeated on the cross. And all this because of love. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The people of Israel, when they were saved from the poison, they recommitted their lives to God. And same for you and I. Got to do. Might be we are complaining. Might be we are grumbling. And the poison has entered in us. But today is the day the God gives us remedy. He says, everyone who looks at my son Jesus and accepts the sacrifice that he took our place on the cross, the poison from our life will be removed by Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Every poison can be taken care of by Jesus. And once the poison is removed and he gives us new life, we have to turn our life Jesus and recommit our life to Jesus. And that's what the people of Israel did. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And that's why the Bible says, God so loved the world that he gave. When we love somebody, we have to give. Our Christian life is giving, not receiving. If we call ourselves Christian, then the Christian life is give, and God shows a beautiful example. He displays on the cross when he has only one son, and God is ready to show that one son completely for you and me. He did not say, for God so loved the world that he took, that he gave. The whole principle in the God's kingdom, the kingdom of God, on a principle called sowing and reaping. God has only one son. His name is Jesus. And he took his only son and offered his son willingly. And he gave all that he had for his son to die on the cross. He emptied himself. Jesus emptied himself completely. And what did he reap? God gave one son, and the son died on the cross. And after that, he put that power in him and raised Jesus from the dead. The moment Jesus rose from the dead, he opened the door for you and me to come out of death and eternal life. And God sowed one son, and he reaped sons and daughters, all of us as a family. God sowed one son, his son Jesus, and God reaped sons and daughters, all of us as a family. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And that is what love is. Love is to give everything of you and me. And when we give it out of love, it will multiply and come to us. And God showed of the example of the Son. God sowed one seed and reaped what you and me. Did God reap with force? Did he reap us with love? Yes. Did God force you and me to come to this meeting? No. When a person cultivates love in his life, God kind life in his life, he is the only person who experienced the wholeness of God in his life. Love is that power of God that attracts the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And God is love, and a person who operates in love attracts God all the time. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. When we operate in love, we attract God all the time in our life. The gifts of the Holy Spirit operate only when the person operating in love. The Bible says in Galatians 5:6, faith works through love. So, if a person cultivating love in his life, he finds the God's anointing began to increase according to the level of love. Have you ever heard the word power? What is power? Power is love. According to the word of God, the love flowing in you and me. And when we operate on the power, God will operate on the same level. And if we read in 1 Corinthians 13, if I speak in tongue of mortals and angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have gift of speaking in tongues, I can speak the language of angels. But if I have no love, I am only making noise. In other words, if we have the gift of the Holy Spirit, we have no love, then the gift is useless. God has given each one of us different gifts. Please listen carefully. The word of God, Proverbs 18 says, it is the gift of a person that makes a room for him. And this gift will lead that person, great man. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Your very gift, when you begin to use, will help you to reach your destination. God has given us, each one of us has blessed us with different kinds of gifts. He has given us different kinds of gifts because each one of us called for different purposes. A gift is that power or that ability God has put in us. By using that gift, is able to build the kingdom of God. Through our gift, God wants to build the kingdom of God. And the same gift God uses for his kingdom. Those gifts operate in God's kingdom when we operate in love. The same gifts will operate in devil's kingdom also. When we operate in hate, anger, bitterness, hatred. Here St. Paul says, even though I speak all those things, I am useless. If I have a prophetic power, understand all mysteries, all knowledge, if I have all faith, so as to remove mountains, but do not have love. I am nothing. I am useless. I can be a prophet. Prophesy over me and you. I can speak in faith, and in faith move mountain. I can have all the knowledge in the word of God. But if I have no love, I am, because the gifts don't operate in our life. We cannot build the kingdom of God, and we are useless to the kingdom of God. Without love, we are useless. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And then Paul says, if I give away all my possession and I hand over all that I have, I am useless. Listen carefully, attentively. God has not designed man to chase blessing, but man has been designed by God to chase God, because man cannot live without love, because God is a love. We have to live. So love is the key factor that moves God. If we want to move God on our behalf, then we have to seek love. Love is that gift from God that when we possess it, it attracts God, and God will always, always move on our behalf. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. That's why Jesus said, seek you first the kingdom of God in Matthew 6:33. Jesus said, seek you first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and everything else will be added unto you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Here Jesus means to say, seek you first the love. Seek you first love and the fruits of love, and all will be added unto you. I hope you are all understanding. Because when we seek love and the fruits of love, and all that we need will be added into our love. Because when we are in love, when we operate in love, and God moves on behalf of us, and he works miracles, signs and wonders in our life. Now, what are we doing? We are seeking all the other things, and we fail to operate in love. Listen carefully. That's why we have to seek love first. And when we begin to seek love all the time, love will attract the blessings, and blessings will come chasing after you and me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise to Jesus. And the devil will teach us the other way around us. He says, listen, there is time for God. First you go and search for some blessings and start seeing them and start chasing blessing. And we find we further going away from God, further away from love. We are frustrated. Things are not happening in our way. We want. So all that is we speaking in today's world. If we are seeking love, then only we will attract God. And the blessings will come into our life searching for us. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I give you another example. We all want to be greatly blessed. Yes, surely yes. Supposing somebody hurting you and me. Are we able to love that person? One question. Do people hurt us? Practically every day, we get hurt by our own people, from our loved ones, in our workplace, in our friend circles. Now, when they hurt us, are we able to love them? Why not? Because our thoughts having an authority over our spirit. Man's nature is to retaliate. Man's nature is to take revenge. Man's nature is to give back. That is that nature implanted into man when Adam committed sin. We all know that we are not a sinner. we are not commit sin, but we are made a sinner, even when we are in mother's womb. So it is man's nature to retaliate. Now the Bible says in 1 Peter 3:9, it says, do not repay evil with evil. Once again I read. 1 Peter 3:9 says, do not repay evil with evil. Now, if somebody insults us, what happened in your spirit? Somebody abuses us, what happened to us? We get angry quickly. Yes or no? Yes, we get angered. And what is the meaning of angry? The meaning of angry is we say to God, God, I don't trust in you. God, I don't believe you that you love me. That what it means? It means I think you cannot control the situation that I am going through, that I am going, God. Please, you take some rest. And I do. Let me go. And I let me go to the battle. And I will tackle my own way. That is anger. If you trust the Lord, Lord is fighting the battle for you. You are going to remain calm and cool. Because when you trust the Lord, you know, whatever I am going through the situation, whatever I am facing in trouble, whatever the when people hurt me, you know, God is, I trust in the Lord. He is battling for me. And he will, so I will surely come out that. Suppose, for example, if we are watching one day cricket match live, and that time we don't know the end result. And that's why sometimes we are started biting the nails with excitement. Sometimes we are jumping, but when the match has won, we are enjoying, we are clapping. The same match, if we are watching it as the highlight. Now we reach the highlights. Are we biting the nails? Now, no. Because we know the result. But we are still dance because we know the end result. We want to celebrate that victory when we are finding losing. We are not bothered. Why? Because we know the end result. Is it the same with the promise of God? Yes. God has given us the end result, saying, listen, just follow my instruction in love, and I will guide you through. But what we are saying, oh Lord, you are taking too much time. Let me go in. And every time we got angry, did we win the battle? When the whole episode was over, we say, my God, why did I open my mouth and speak that word? And we apologize, we repent. And did we see the enemy made everything, see it to that we open our mouth and we speak words which did not even want to speak? Isn't this happening in our life? Yes, it happens in my life. Before that, when I don't know the truth. That's why the Bible says, do not repay evil with evil, insult with insult, but on contrary, repay evil with blessing. God says, if somebody is hurting you, turn around. And even if you don't feel like, you keep saying, Father, in the name of Jesus, I bless that person, I bless him. Listen, brothers and sisters, to bless somebody is not your and my own feelings. The good news is everything is in the Bible is not on our feeling, but on our believing. What we believe. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It is not our emotion. It is only believing, believing, believing. If we feel bad and we turn around a blessing, that person taking the decision in the name of Jesus, now God's love flows to you, to me, and overcome that weakness of hatred out of you and me. When God's love flows us, every anger is destroyed. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So, when we take a decision, no matter what is happening, from now on, I train myself. I am going to bless everybody. And when we do this, the Bible says, you shall inheriting a great blessing. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise to Jesus. When we are praying, asking God, bless me, we are receiving the blessing. Yes, we receive the blessing, but in slow, it is in a small portion. But somebody is hurting you, and you are turning around and blessing that person with love. Now, you are able to get great blessing. Just check our life. How many great blessings we missed in our life? I missed a lot of blessings in my life earlier. From now on, if we take a decision, no matter what happens, I am going to bless somebody. I am going to bless. If somebody might say over here, if I don't retaliate, that fellow come and sit in my head. We always say now that I want justice. The world teaches you justice. Jesus could have the same, but Jesus could have said it also. I could not commit a single sin. Pilate, listen, I could not commit a single sin. I want justice. But the Bible says in Peter 1, we should read 1st chapter 1 Peter and see in the midst of suffering, how can we change over and get blessed? Peter is saying in 1 Peter 2:18 onwards, even though Jesus was insulted, he was abused, he was threatened, and he did not threaten them. But on the contrary, Jesus handled insult. The one judge's justice, Jesus hand over to the judges for justice. And because of what he did, God exalted him. And that's how he began to operate in love. And he displayed his love on the cross when he took all our sins, our curse, our bondages, our captivity, our sickness. And he said, Father, forgive them. So, if we fail to will bless them, somebody hurting us, forgive them. We do not forgive them very person when they hurt us. Just speak the same word Jesus has spoken in the cross, and we will all automatically get forgiven them. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. So from today onwards, we operate in love. When a person hurts us, he abuses us, in spite of retaliating, bless them in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, I am blessing that person. And the moment when we say this, God's love flowing in our heart and God's moves on our behalf. And we see manifestation of our life. Our prayer get answered. Thank you, Jesus. Praise to Jesus. Love you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
Thank you, brother.
Thank you, brother.